Whilst we're still on the subject of the artistic text tool, I know a lot of people, when you first start, maybe you want to curve text around a shape, maybe like a circle. Well, I'm going to cover that just so you know how to do it. So you can head on over to the left-hand side and grab your ellipse, click on that, and just click and drag out like this. Okay, let's say you want to type around this circle here. Well, you can head on over to the artistic text tool, just select that. And now with that, you can just head on over, and in fact, I should probably change the color of this because we're not seeing everything. Maybe I'll make it this color. Okay, I'll click on the artistic text tool again. And you see, as I come close, there's a little T there. And that means that it's ready for me to lay down my text. So I can click, and you see I've got really big text there, so I'm just going to make that smaller. Maybe I'll make it like 30 pixels. And from this point, I can start typing. So I'll write the same thing again. I'll do it all in capitals this time. Artistic. Yeah, I'll just call it artistic for now. Okay, so from this point, you can see that on the left and on the right, there's these two little triangles. What are they? Well, basically, they are allowing you to drag and kind of place into the center here. And I can grab this one here and drag that. So now with both of these being kind of snapped into place, I know that that is centered up there. And I can keep typing as well. Right now it's set to align to center. So every time I type now, it should always be centered. So I could type in text tool. So at this point you could play around with the baseline grid. So head on up to the context toolbar, click on that, and then you could just drag this up and down. Maybe you want it to be kind of centered on that circle line there. So that's one thing you can do. Also, I should probably show you that if you go back on the move tool and you click and rescale, it will actually rescale with the circle. So you see what's happening here. And if you go even lower, you see, oh, look, I've got another line here. Or if you want to rescale and you don't want it to do that, you can click on, you see this little circle here. You just click on that and you can resize down. And it won't affect the text at all. But going back to that other piece of text, you saw another one underneath, didn't you? Well, if we head on up, if I just double tap that, let me zoom in. If I press return now, it will go to the bottom half. So I can type something else again. Affinity Designer. Okay, great. Doesn't look very centered, does it? Well, I could just grab this little triangle here, place it up here. It kind of snaps into place. And I can head over here, and there's a green one just kind of hiding, actually. I almost missed that. Slightly darker green. So now that I know that's centered and I can go to the baseline grid, let's say for this lot here, I could just click and select. I can go to baseline grid, click and drag it out a little bit like that. And of course, from this point, you can do whatever you want, but you can grab the ellipse tool again and just click and drag out. Maybe you want a circle here and maybe a picture, photo or something like that. But basically that's how to type around a circle, and that can work with the pen tool as well. So you could just click with the pen tool, make some kind of shape like that, and then you could go up to the artistic text tool again, sorry, and then just click and start typing. And then you can go on the node tool and you can start playing around with the node and maybe to fine tune it to your liking. So that's the artistic text tool.